I just want to say thank you to all the media that travelled out here. I want to say thank you as well to Prince Khalid, Prince Abdulaziz, the GSA Skills Challenge Entertainment for just the most amazing experience out here. And I want to say thank you to the Matchroom Boxing team, Frank Smith, everybody on board, to Freddie Cunningham, Andy Bell, 258 Management. And I want to say thank you as well to Anthony Joshua, because to come back from that defeat at Madison Square Garden was tough. You know, people doubted him. People said that he might not have the hunger for the sport anymore, and he went away. And, you know, I knew how disappointed he was, and he bounced back. He showed that heart to come back, and he went back, and he learned, and he improved, and he's a student of the game. And there were so many more improvements that Anthony Joshua will make, and tonight was an absolute masterclass to become a two-time world heavyweight champion. So we're going to go to the floor now for questions for the champion.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. How are you? Good, good.
You did well, but I must confess, I expected more from you as a professional boxer.
You did well, but I expected more from you as a professional boxer. You won tonight. What would you do to ensure that you maintain the title you have earned tonight? What strategy will you put in place to ensure that you maintain it?
It's difficult to answer that question, because when you're facing all the challenges, different sizes, different styles, some people are pressure fighters, some people are counter punchers. In boxing, you're going to have good nights and bad nights in the heavyweight division. So all I can do is try my best, make my prayers, stay dedicated, and just do it for myself. You know, if I box for the crowd or box for people's opinion, and I might not have been victorious tonight. I boxed in my own game plan, I trusted my own process, and now I'm the champion, so I'm just going to follow my own instincts while I'm boxing.
Elie, on the other side, what a great fight you had tonight. I noticed that you were able to keep the distance between you and RUIZ. Was that part of your strategy?
I can knock people out when I want it, and I can box when I want to. So tonight was just about winning and trusting my process. I know maybe I could have done more at times, but sometimes simplicity is genius. And that was the motto. Just keep it simple, because it's going to lead to a genius performance. So it was outclassing the current champion, and just kind of proving to myself is that every time I step in the ring, sometimes I may take a loss, but if I prepare myself well, I don't think anyone's going to beat me. And I just take it back to the old school, 70s style, boxing sweet science, hit and don't get hit. That's the name of the game.
Bismillah, Anthony Joshua, congrats again on the win. Nazir from ESPN Los Angeles. I just had to ask you, you know, out of all your opponents that you fought, you know, most of them you've knocked out, you know, barely any of them you've ever gone to the distance. What is different about Andy Ruiz that, you know, you got your first loss from him, but then you bounced back, but still he took you to the distance? What's the difference? Because when it comes to your boxing, it looks like, you know, you can outbeat him easily. But what's the difference with him compared to your other opponents when it comes to his challenges?
I think belief is important. I think he believes in himself, which is very important. He's very humble outside of the ring. And most people that are humble outside of the ring, they're definitely a threat inside the ring, because I don't think they need to fake a character, like build up a full sense of an ego to prove that there's something that they're not. But I feel like he can definitely fight. He has his countrymen behind him, which gives you a different kind of energy. Not just people who support you when you're winning, he has people who support him because they have the same blood as him, and that is like a real type of energy that can't be denied. And he has his father beside him. You know, a lot of kids need their parents in their life for guidance. So his father has done a great job with him to kind of raise him and keep him on track since he was 6 years old. So these are the things that make Andy Ruiz a lot different. That was my hand.
How much did the loss hurt you?
I've always had it in me, and I said like, oh, when I win, they said, how are you going to celebrate? I said, I don't really want to celebrate because I know I belong here. It was mainly just the discipline. I had some of my own issues. Andy said that he had his issues. The things that come along with being a champion. Andy's a really nice guy, so it might have been hard to say no to certain things as well. But I just knew what was always in me. And on June 1st, I just got beat by the better man, and I just knew that I belong at a championship level. So the belt spent some time with me. The belts have spent some time with Andy. And I think the belts realized that they want to be around my waist. So they came home tonight. And as I always say, I'm only champion until the next time I go out, because champions don't live forever. I came today, I'm victorious, and then I have to put them up in the air for the next competitor. And looking at the card today, you see all of the challenges that are hungry. And it's just going to be an interesting time in every division, because you guys, I want to thank you guys for being here as well. And it's just an interesting time in the heavyweight division. I'm just loving it.
Question from BBC. Yeah.
Anthony, two weeks ago you told Mike Costello you might drop on your YouTube channel what happened last time in the build-up to the fight. On Monday you said it twice again, you talked about obstacles. Is there anything you can enlighten us with what happened before June the 1st?
Yeah, Andy just beat me. Credit to the man. He beat me fair and square. He's a great fighter, a great champion. First ever Mexican heavyweight champion. You know, he has something special about him. But we just reclaimed what was rightfully ours. And that's all. I just got beat by the better man. And it shows that we're just as good as each other. You know, he beat me, I beat him. And we move on to the next.
Mike, I'll pitch
you. Congratulations on the victory.
Thank you, sir.
You said before the fight that it wouldn't be special if you wouldn't celebrate at all. Instead, you had like an hour-long celebration in the ring that, like, one of the most epic I've ever seen. It was just so much better than you imagined it, or was that just the mindset that you had to have before?
You ride the wave. You ride the energy. Deep down in my heart, I'm chill. I'm calm, I'm collected, I believe in myself. I just ride the wave of the crowd. People who were happy, my family were there, my friends I grew up with were there. So I had to kind of fill in with that energy, you know. But deep down, honestly, for me, I'm relaxed. It is what it is.
You talked a lot about your friendship now with Vladimir Klitschko and how much advice he's given you. You fought a lot like him, I thought, very tactical and disciplined.
Yes.
How much influence did he have on the strategy and the way you fought?
Nothing to do with strategy, that's my trainer. Nothing to do with strategy, but just about mindset, I feel. So Vladimir Klitschko, even though we've been in the ring and we were enemies to a certain degree, I feel like we have a lot of mutual respect, and that's the great thing about boxing, is that you do go to war, however you shake each other's hands after. Me and Vladimir kept a good relationship. He's just been in the game for such a long time. I keep myself around boxing people who know the game, and any type of information and knowledge can lead me on to success. So he passed on a lot of his experiences, which play a part in my mental preparation.
AJ, Adi Oladipo here for ESPN Africa. As a fellow Nigerian, extremely proud of what you've done today.
Thank you so
much. All of Nigeria has gone crazy. What inspired the ringwalk music today?
So when I went to Nigeria, I met Femi Akuti. And more so than his music, the conversation he gave me, he sat me down and he spoke to me about some of the good things in Nigeria, some of the issues in Nigeria and so on. And when I went back, I listened to some of his music, and that song, Fight to Win, really has deep meaning, really has deep meaning. And then his father, Fela, my dad always listened to him, but when we were sparring, I'm one of them guys that just put the song on repeat. It's quite annoying for everyone else, but I'm a simple kind of guy, so I was just repeating that song on loop. And what I wanted to do was just create the same environment I had in training, coming to the ring. So it was just stuff that I listen to while I'm preparing. So when I'm sparring 12 rounds and stuff like that, we have the music playing in the background, there's about 50 people screaming. And it was just to create the same environment, so I'm comfortable walking to the ring, and it's not new to me.
Anthony.
Hello.
What did you and Ruiz say when you guys had that moment in the ring? You guys kind of hugged, talked it out a little bit. What was that? What did you guys say, and what was that moment like?
To never give up. I just told him to never give up. It's tough. You're a great man, first of all. And you're a great champion as well. But I told him to never give up and just keep on chasing his dream. Boxing is really tough. But he's created his own history, he's created his own legacy. And I created mine tonight, and I'm glad we could both play a part in each other's legacy. So I just kind of gave him a pound on the back and said, I'm sure I'll see you again.
Hi, Anthony. Congratulations on the win tonight.
Thank you, bro.
It's not really hard to put out that you have to...
In 180 days?
Yeah.
That's what I'm wrong, mate.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'll just go lose it.
No problem.
No chance at...
No, there's an IBF mandatory, there's a WBO mandatory. Tonight's about celebrating the victory, and as he's always done, his first mandatory, which Kubrat Pulev, he pulled out. He faced Carlos Takam on a week's notice. His WBA mandatory was Alexander Povetkin. Nobody wanted to fight Alexander Povetkin at the time. He took care of that mandatory as well. Kubrat Pulev is the IBF mandatory. Alexander Usyk is a WBO mandatory, and I see him wanting to take both of those fights as well. So we'll have to speak to the governing body, see who goes first, and then deal with that. Anthony will have a nice Christmas and holiday. We'll work behind the scenes and plan for the future.
Christmas, yeah, but holiday, I'm still training. That's the key to this business, to stay active, stay in the gym. So I learned, you know, being heavily promoting boxing. When I become champion after 16 fights, you know, like fighting twice a year, when a fighter needs to develop, like 24 fights, I think, the championship, I learned that you can't spend a lot of time out of the gym. You have to kind of stay consistent. So, a little holiday, yeah, but I'm going to stay consistent because that's going to lead me to another victory and another defense of my title.
AJ, congrats tonight. Andy, straight after the fight, said that he would be happy to see any potential third fight back here in Saudi Arabia. Are you happy with that prospect as well?
The great thing is his view on Saudi Arabia, that's a positive because he was a bit weary at first, so it's nice to see that he's changed his opinion. Has everyone had a good time here? I think everyone's had a good time here, which is nice. So it's a neutral ground, neutral territory, so he's keen. Alexander, Usyk, Pulev, Ruiz. I don't want to mention the other guy's name, you know who they are. When they're ready. You know, I fought a lot of great names on my record, and I've beaten some good names as well, and I'm looking forward to taking on more challenges. And Andy's still on that list because I think we make for good music. He's a good dancing partner.
AJ, congratulations.
Hello, how are you?
Boris Jovicic, champion television, Croatia. Is there a wish to unite all the belts, the Beyond the Valor fight?
Yeah, definitely. I would love to, definitely. I've united for it's hard, it's difficult to keep them, it's difficult to unite them. And I'm sure PBC were desperately rooting for Andy to win. But we came and put a little spanner in their way. But we'll see what happens, man. I'd love to unite the belts, but I think me chasing, same as in the fight, sometimes if I'm chasing the right hand or I'm chasing the left hook, it may come crashing down. And I realize that chasing that fight wasn't playing into my benefit. So I'm just going to let the path take its course. I've got great people managing me. I've got a great team. And when the opportunity presents itself to become undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, you know me by now, I'll definitely step up and take the challenge.
Guys, we can have two more questions, please.
Yeah. Anthony, to your left.
Hello.
Salvador Rodriguez from ESPN. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
And then, do you feel that this victory was a kind of different after your first loss? Do you feel that this is like a refreshment in your career? After the win, like KO.
Yeah, it's nice to KO. Like, there was times that I looked in Andy's eyes and I wanted to put my fist through his head. But then I...